Holly Garrett, Liquor Cannabis Board member, and I am here today in support of the bill.
Of the striking amendment or of the underlying bill?
Of the underlying bill.
What about the striking amendment?
I didn't hear the striking amendment before I got here.
Richard, would you refresh us about what the three things, elements are in the striking amendments, and we're all on the same page on this bill?
You bet. The striking amendment includes about 20 technical changes that were suggested by the LCB.
But go ahead.
And I'm not sure of the striking amendment part myself yet, but I am in full support of the bill.
Hi, my name is Peter Manning. I'm also with Black Excellence in Cannabis. And just to give a proper perspective of what we're dealing with here, you have the only black LCB member, the board member, come here before you today and couldn't even tell you the groundwork for social equity. That's exactly the system we're dealing with. Rick Garza, Rebecca Smith, all of them guys that put a racist institution in play. It started back in 2014. They had many people, publications, newspapers, people testifying before them and said, hey, there's no black people in this market. They completely ignored that. This bill puts them back in control of the same thing. They already got a bunch of their cronies and whatever faces they have for those licenses. They're not going to make it to the people that they need to make it to. And it was evident today, because if their board member didn't know what that social equity bill spoke of, or what it included, what was stricken for, and she's black, to represent black people, that's sad. That says volumes to everybody in this room today, including me. That bill stinks, period.